When Ford first announced that they were bringing in the Ranger Raptor to the Philippines, there was a genuine sense of excitement from the public.
That kind of hype is usually reserved for sporty sedans and SUVs, certainly not pickups. But this is no ordinary pickup. This is the Raptor, and it bears the legendary Raptor name. And it's more than just a blacked-out badge that's been stuck on the back of the truck. I mean, just look at this thing. It looks like it swallowed two regular Rangers and morphed into a super truck. The Raptor certainly has the kind of looks that grab you by the neck. But how does it perform? Well, that is what we're here to find out. Hey guys, welcome to REV, your ultimate guide to choosing your next ride. For this week, we finally have it, the 2019 Ford Ranger Raptor. Now let's quickly talk about what's underneath the hood. It is a 2-liter bi-turbo engine that produces 213 horsepower and gives you a mighty 500 newton meters of torque. All that power can go down to all four wheels. It is a four-wheel drive after all. And that power plant is connected to a 10-speed automatic gearbox. Now, much of the hype surrounding the Raptor really centers around its looks, and deservedly so. I don't think there's another vehicle out there that has quite the imposing presence that the Raptor has. Let's start by talking about the front. You won't miss this blacked out front grille, which spells out Ford. This is a bit of a trademark for the Raptor series. It works really well with these very aggressive HID headlamps in a smoke design. Daytime running lights across the outside of it makes it look very masculine. You've got the blacked out front bumper, which is frame mounted, which makes a nice contrast with the metal skid plate that you find underneath here. Now, viewed from the side, you really won't miss these huge fenders, very wide, the very edge of it done up in a contrasting black. Now, Ford widened the track by 6 inches, but you won't find any spacers here. They used forged aluminum control arms to bring those wheels out so they could use these very wide, knobby off-road tires. You've got some nice chunky rims, which work very well with the blacked out step board. Very important for a tall vehicle like this for ingress and egress. Now, speaking of the height,
we've got 283 millimeters of ground clearance, very high.
It'll run over any obstacle on the road, even small cars. Coupled with that is an 850 millimeter wading depth, which is class leading. Now, it's not just about looks. The Raptor has got performance to boot. Underneath here, you will find Fox Racing suspension components. There are no leaf springs here, only quality performance-oriented coilovers, which really aid in the off-road capabilities of the Raptor. Now, viewed from the rear, you've got the blacked-out Raptor badges, some really nice tail lamps, and overall, this is how you want an off-road vehicle to look after you've spent maybe tens, hundreds of thousands on it. Except with the Raptor, you get it looking like this, straight out of the factory. Now, on the inside, Ford maintains its sporty aspirations for the Raptor by giving us this very sporty steering wheel that greets us here towards the front. Nice round, classic shape, nice leather wrap, very well contoured. Now, a very interesting feature is this center stripe they have here, which apparently is very important to off-roaders so that you know, or it's easy to tell which way your wheels are pointed. Now, much of the same color scheme of this charcoal gray with contrast blue stitching that you see here in the steering wheel is carried across much of the interior. You'll see it here on the dash with the contrast stitching, and you'll also find it on these fantastic sports seats that come with the Raptor. Now, these are beautifully designed, very well contoured, nicely bolstered, and obviously very off-road oriented. Now, right in front of us is the main instrument cluster. Let's start her up. Now, you get a really nice startup sequence here towards the infotainment system and your main instrument cluster. Check it out. Nice animation. Really puts you in that mood. Now, we've got two main clocks here, analog tachometer, analog speedometer on the right, and right between those is digital screen, which gives you access to information like your fuel capacity, how much distance you have before you need to gas up. It also gives you access to the different driving modes that you have. The main terrain modes are normal, sport, you've got grass or gravel and snow. You've also got mud. You've got Baja, which is what this vehicle is all about, going full tilt boogie across surfaces like this. And you've got your other mode, which is rock, which is sort of crawling over rocky terrain. Now, we're gonna go back into our default, which is normal mode, and see where we go from there. All right, in terms of a infotainment system, Ford gives us this as the main head unit. It is an 8-inch touchscreen. Now, you'll notice that it's already displaying my Apple CarPlay functions. I was able to connect my iPhone very easily using a hard cable, plug it in, and almost instantly you get instant CarPlay functionality. That means all your main apps are mirrored here. You've got navigational apps like Waze. You've got your messages, which can be read to you. It will take dictation if you want to reply to that message, as well as your usual phone contacts. Now, all of that is made possible by the great user interface that Ford gives us, which is Ford Sync 3. This is both Apple CarPlay and Android Auto compatible. Now, here towards the center, we have our main stack. We've got physical buttons for our climate control. We've got a dual climate zone happening here. The temperature for the driver is separately set from the passenger. You've also got unusual features like a CD slot. Remember those? Who uses those? We've also got two USB charging points. We've got a 12-volt charger here towards the front. You've got your main control for your differential. You can go from two-wheel high to four-wheel high. Even while the car is moving, you need to stop and put the transmission into neutral when you want to drop into four-wheel low. Now, towards the back, you've got full seating for three adults. It looks quite comfortable. There's quite a bit of leg space and headroom. You've also got the center armrest, which can be dropped to add a little bit of comfort and functionality for your cup holders. From here, let's take a look at the tailgate and flat top. Now, this is what the back or the flatbed of the Raptor looks like. It's quite roomy. Bed liner is standard. Plus, you get a really cool 12-volt charging port right over here. Multiple tie-down points. Plus, you'll notice the third brake light, which is actually something that lights up the flatbed at night. You'll also notice that this is a very light assisted tailgate. am particularly excited about driving the Ranger Raptor because I drive a pickup myself as a daily driver. I drive the earlier Ranger 4x2 XLT. They certainly share a little bit of DNA, but this is a completely different animal. Right now we're driving in one of the many different presets that we have is something they call normal mode. But so far it's performing really well for a very off-road oriented vehicle. I think the real standout when it comes to the Raptor is the suspension. It's a totally different sensation to driving a more utility-oriented pickup. That's because of the Fox Racing suspension that's been spec'd on the Raptor. There are no leaf springs here on the back, so it's a much more sort of off-road oriented setup. It's quite tall, and the damping quality of these shocks are just beautiful. If they work well off-road, think about how they feel on a smooth or relatively smooth road of the city. When you're in a smaller car, you're generally sort of dodging those potholes, looking at the smoothest path. When you're in a taller car, you give yourself a little bit more leeway, but when you're driving a Raptor, you just run over anything you want. Potholes, bumps, humps, imperfections, even smaller cars. This car will swallow them all because of the suspension system. The steering doesn't feel particularly compromised by those large knobby tires. You're not getting a lot of tire roar from the more off-road oriented tires. It feels quite good in the city. Nowadays, pickups are expected to perform many different duties. Whereas before they were viewed as much more sort of utility vehicles, now they pull double duty. They've generally become family cars. People use them as daily drivers. They drop off the kids, drive themselves to work, pick up groceries. This car will do it all. Now this is where the Ford Ranger Raptor wants to play. This is what it was built for, off-road trails. So let's get it into one of its off-road modes. I'm gonna go with Baja, which is what this vehicle is all about. Now the Ranger Raptor, as we start rolling off, is a vehicle that was primarily designed not for slow rock crawling, but really more for traveling fast over challenging terrain like we have here. And that is what Baja mode is all about. You really make the most out of the Fox suspension that has been fitted on this vehicle, the type of clearance, the type of power that this 2-liter bi-turbo engine produces. And you can really just sort of let her rip and go full tilt boogie over challenging terrain like we have over here. So let's take in a few rounds. Go for a few kilometers over this rough terrain and see how we do. All right, here we go. Let's pitch it into this corner. Yeah! All right, let's get it into here. Got a bit of sand. Over challenging terrain, let's hit the gas. All right, now the shocks feel really, really good. This is quite rough off-road conditions that we have here, but it feels really quite manageable with the Fox suspension. Again, this is a sand, loose sandy surface. As we come in here, let's pitch it in, put the power on, let her drift out. All right, here we go.